Hi everyone, this is me, Jasneet Kaur. Welcome back to my channel. If you watch my videos on regular basis, you must be aware of that we have already completed chapter 3 in the last two parts. So in today's video, we will be doing the recapitulation of important key terms as well as we will overlook the topics we have covered so far. But before beginning with the content, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. Do hit the bell icon for regular updates. Let's look at the topics we have covered in the previous two parts of this chapter. We have discussed about meaning of food, nutrition, health and fitness and their role in maintaining health, meaning of balanced diet and its concepts, recommended dietary allowance, basic classification of foods on the basis of different food groups, factors which affect adolescents' food habits and eating disorders. Now let's recapitulate the key terms of this chapter which we have covered so far. Starting with activity level. Level of activity of a person always divided into three categories. The first one is sedentary or light activity, second moderate activity and third heavy activity. Talking about sedentary lifestyle or sedentary activity, it includes those profiles or those work profiles which majorly include the time where the person is sitting most of the time. Example of this can be people working in IT companies, receptionists, or any material packers. Moderate activity include some physical activity which include brisk walk, gardening, or household chores. Talking about heavy activity, it includes lot of physical work. Example of this can be running, fast cycling, fast swimming, or construction work, etc. Moving on to our next term, that is balanced diet. It is a diet which includes a variety of foods in adequate amount, in correct proportions from all the food groups to meet the nutritional requirement of an individual. Next one is food group. So food group is collection of food that share similar nutritional properties or biological classifications. The parameters on which these food groups are divided can be function, nutrient or source. Next one is lactation. Lactation is a stage where milk is produced and secreted by females after giving birth. Physiological state or condition is a term used in biology, biochemistry, and medicine. It refers to the internal or external environment of any organism. Next one is recommended dietary allowance. It is also known as RDA. These are the guidelines which tell us the amount of nutrient to be consumed on daily basis. Moving on to fitness, it is defined as the body's ability to function efficiently and effectively in work and in leisure activities. Talking about nutrition, it is the study of how food and drinks affect our bodies, especially in the context of the nutrients required for healthy human growth. Macronutrients. Macro means large. These are those nutrients which your body requires in large amount in order to function properly. Example of macronutrients can be carbohydrates, protein, fats, fiber, and water. On the other hand, micronutrients. These are those nutrients which your body requires in small amounts, like vitamins, iron, zinc, iodine, and manganese. Food guide pyramid is a graphic depiction of the daily food guide. It depicts variety, moderation, and also the proportion. Moving on to vegetarian food guide. So this helps people who are vegetarian and vegan to choose alternate diets to animal products. Like the people who are non-vegetarian, at the place of meat, they can opt options like consuming legumes, seeds, nuts, tofu, green leafy vegetables on everyday basis. And the people who are vegan, rather than drinking animal milk, they can choose options like almond milk or soy milk. Next, we have covered dietary pattern in adolescence. In this, we have covered how irregular meals and skipping meals, snacking, fast food, and dieting leaves impact on the overall health of adolescents. For more clarity, please check out the links mentioned in the description box below, or you can click on the top right corner of this video. The next topic which we have covered is modifying diet-related behavior. In this, we have covered that how we can modify the diet-related issues amongst adolescents. Next, we have talked about various factors which influence the eating behavior of the adolescents, as well as we have covered eating disorders which are pretty common amongst adolescents. In this, basically, we have covered two types of the disorders, anorexia nervosa and bulimia nervosa. For the better clarity what both of these disorders are, please check out the links mentioned in the description box below. So students, if I talk about today's lecture, we have covered terms like activity level, balanced diet, food group, lactation, physiological state, RDA, fitness, nutrition, macro and micronutrients, food groups, vegetarian food guide, dietary pattern in adolescence, modifying diet-related behavior, factors influencing eating behaviors, and eating disorders. I hope students, whatever we have covered so far is clear to you. If you still come across any problem, you can certainly ask me during online classes, or you can mention in the comment section below. Don't forget to mention your feedback about this video as well. I'll see you soon with my next video. Till then, stay tuned.